In this video, we will study changes in ventricular pressure during a cardiac cycle. Let's get started. We know that the heart has two ventricles. During the cardiac cycle, similar events occur in both the ventricles. So, the type of pressure changes is also similar. The main difference is that the pressure on the right ventricle is on lower side as compared to that in left ventricle at any given point in the cycle. We will be discussing the pressure in the left ventricle, but please keep in mind that similar changes are occurring in right ventricle also. With that thing clear, now let's study the pressure changes in the left ventricle during a cardiac cycle. We will start our discussion with atrial systole. During this, contraction of the atria pumps blood into the ventricles. This causes a rise in the ventricular pressure. By this time, the impulse has stimulated the ventricular musculature. So the ventricles start contracting. The rise in the ventricular pressure closes atrioventricular valves. Then comes the phase of isovolumetric contraction. During this, ventricles contract as closed chambers. So there is a sharp rise in the pressure. Soon, the pressure rises above that in the major arteries. So semilunar valves open. The ventricles continue to contract and initially there is a rapid ejection of blood. During this, pressure rises and reaches the maximum. Then the ejection is slowed down. During this, the pressure falls. Now the semilunar valves close. Then the ventricles relax as closed chambers. This results in a sharp fall in the pressure. Eventually, the pressure falls below that in the atria. So atrioventricular valves open. Then the blood rushes into the ventricles. Despite this failing, the pressure continues to fall because the ventricles are relaxing. Then, with a continued filling of blood from veins through the atria into the ventricles, the pressure gradually rises. This completes the entire cycle. The next cycle begins with the atrial contraction, and this pumping causes a slight rise in the ventricular pressure. So this is how pressure changes during a cardiac cycle. Now let's see the changes in graphical form. Initially, atrial contraction causes a slight rise in pressure. At this point, the atrioventricular valves close. Then, an isovolumetric contraction of the ventricles produces a sharp rise. This point marks the opening of semilunar valves. Now, during rapid ejection, the pressure continues to rise and reaches the maximum. And during slow ejection, the pressure starts to fall. Then the semilunar valves close, and during isovolumetric relaxation, the pressure falls sharply. At this point, the atrioventricular valves open and ventricles start getting filled. During this, continued relaxation of ventricles causes a fall in pressure. Then pressure gradually starts rising due to the continued flow of blood. This is one cycle. The next cycle begins with atrial contraction. This produces a rise in pressure as we have seen in the beginning. In this graph, this part is ventricular systole and this is diastole. To be more precise, this is isovolumetric relaxation during which there is a sharp rise in pressure. This is the ejection phase. During rapid ejection, there is an increase in pressure and the pressure reaches maximum. Later during slow ejection, the pressure falls. This is isovolumetric relaxation where we see a sharp fall in pressure. This is rapid ventricular filling. This is diastasis. And this is atrial systole. So these are the pressure changes in the left ventricle. Now as I said in the beginning, the right ventricle follows a similar pattern, but the pressures are on lower side. For example, the maximum pressure in left ventricle is 120 mmHg, whereas that in the right ventricle is about 25 mmHg. The higher pressure in the left ventricle is due to a thicker wall that generates more force. So this was all about intraventricular pressure during a cardiac cycle. Now let's have a quick summary. atrial systole produces a slight rise in pressure. Isovolumetric contraction produces a sharp increase. During ejection, pressure initially increases, reaches a maximum, and then starts falling. During isovolumetric relaxation, the pressure falls sharply. During ventricular filling, the pressure falls and then gradually starts increasing. Then the next cycle begins with atrial systole. In the graph, this part is systole and this part is diastole. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.